last minute call for some bees. Any of you guys that know me and have been following my channel that are not new viewers, you know I don't do cutouts. If I can help it, I do maybe one a year just to keep my skills up, make a video here and there, and maybe even join up with Mr. Ed. That's about the only reason I do them. But I got a last minute call. I have no idea what I might be getting into, but I'm gonna go take a look. Hey there folks, this is Barry's Best Honey. I'm Mike and I do bees, but I normally don't do bees in November, especially this late in November. It is November 22nd. We're gearing up for Thanksgiving. We're trying to get down the road and do our stuff and get togethers and all that good stuff. But when you do bees and people know you do bees, they want you to come do bees. I don't know where I came up with that junk at. That's I'm passing the dairy. Y'all remember the dairy where I had bees? I don't have bees out there anymore. I don't do bees out there anymore. Anyway, I am literally going to somebody that's got a tree cut out. That's a tree company. All right, y'all know Bruce Mitchell, right? Y'all knew Bruce the Alligator Man from Swamp People? Okay, so he and I, actually, we're going camping together for here in the next week or so, but he knows Rodney, who knows Billy, who knows this guy that does trees. Well, this guy's doing trees right by Billy's house. Who knows Rodney? Who knows Bruce? They find bees in a tree when it hits the ground, comb flies out. The guy knows about bees. He did a little bit with bees. So he calls Rodney, and Bruce tells Rodney, well, Mike does bees. So Rodney calls Billy. Billy calls this fella. This fella calls me, asks me, can I come look at him? I tried and tried to tell him no. I don't do the bees this time of year. I don't do cutouts much. I do one or two a year at the most. And that's usually because I team up with Mr. Ed and we do some. I used to do them on my own a lot. I used to do a lot of cutouts. They burn me out. They're a lot of work. I don't do them. So I said, I've got some doctor's appointments that I'm, you know, just your annual stuff that you do that I'm knocking out these next few days. And I'm on a, in between appointments on a sick day. So I said, I'll go look at them. If it's not too difficult, they got plenty of saws. Maybe we can cut them out. Maybe we can take a gander, see if the queen's there. Throw her in the box if we can find her. Shake some bees, see what happens. Who knows? It couldn't be worst weather. We had a gully washer last night. I mean a gully washer. Y'all in the South know what a gully washer is? We had a gully washer. And now it's cloudy, it's cool, it's misty. They're mad because they fell out of a tree. They drug them over with the tree to move them out of the way so they could continue working. He did say they were gentle. He's been around bees before. He's helped work bees now and again. He said they're gentle for the most part. But man, it's just the worst possible scenario as far as getting stung up. And what am I doing? I'm literally going out there. I got talked into it. He just kept saying, yeah, but they're gonna, yeah, okay. What you gonna do? I'm gonna go look. I always start out with, I'll go look. I always end up doing it though. Let's see what happens. Let me get down the road. It's over in another town over, so gotta zip over there real quick. All right, guys, it went a different direction. I've got a log in the back of my truck full of bees and comb, and the comb's kind of squashed up and banged up, and what we did was I grabbed a chainsaw. We got one that's got an appointment. He's got to go, so we couldn't take long doing this, so I didn't get a chance to get the camera out. And I just grabbed their big chainsaw, I had a 32-inch chainsaw. I cut the ends of it off, and it's already partially opened up, and he's like, look, I get the skid steer, just drop it back in your truck. We called it a day, so that's what we did. Had a bunch of red wasps, so I almost had to put my suit on when I did the cutting, but we got it out. So I cut it to a length. We set it in the back of the truck with a skid steer. I'm gonna take it home and work on it there. It's full of bees. I'm gonna try and take it easy because it's not covered up. But I got her strapped in. So let me get to the house and we'll see what we can do with this thing. All right, guys, I'm here. Here's the log. Okay. I got some of the comb out already. Y'all see it there. I need to hurry up. The only problem with doing what I just did is I'm bringing these things home to a major robbing frenzy that's gonna start in just a little while. I almost wish it would have stayed misty and cooler and overcast. But we got to get busy. So I got my saw. I'm thinking I can, this thing is about to, darn red wasps, man, those red wasps. This is about to break open. If I can break this open, down this crack. Mike can get to it. My goal is to hurry up and grab through that comb and find the queen. I am gonna suit up. They're not happy. They just went on a 15-mile ride through bumpy roads, so gotta get busy. You get it untied. I can roll it over and break that piece out. I think I can get them. I can get to the comb. My goal is simply just dig through and find her. She should be in there. I looked at the residual bees that were out around this log, and she was not there. There's a bunch of red wasps in here. And those things are mean. They're still in here. I've got some good drawn comb I can put her on, and I'll get some honey for her. We'll get a couple frames of honey from some of these nests. I got rid of all my honey in the freezer. Just got tired of having so much old nasty honey. I fed it back, and I just robbed a hive or colony of some honey. There's some that are out there so heavy they won't need it all. Couple things here. I don't want to start a feeding frenzy in my yard. That's one thing. And I don't want a bunch of robbers where I can't tell who's who. That's another thing. So that's kind of what I'm aiming for, getting in a hurry like this.
Ooh, it's heavy.
Yes, I might can break this loose. I'm gonna have to move this a little bit. Now them red wasps, they can get after you now. Yep. It broke open right here. I'm hoping not to have to use a chainsaw. I think I might have to. It's no biggie though. We're dealing with guys right here. So I'm gonna have to try and dig around in there, and she's probably so deep in there it ain't even funny. Let's get busy. I'm gonna probably have to cut more. I'm thinking I'm gonna have to cut. Yeah, actually I will. I'm gonna cut this. Yeah. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut this and this. That'll free up all this and I can get my hand down in here. Oh yeah, there's a bunch of bees there. So I'm gonna start pulling some of this old comb out. With trees like this, hardly any of it's salvageable. We'll melt it, of course, but let's get a box to put them in. We don't want any smoke right now if they're not being ugly, because we don't want to run the queen any further than we need to. We can shake them on some of this comb that's in here, as I can shake them. And I want to box this comb up. Like, that's a piece of brood comb. I do want to save that. No, I don't. Never mind. It's broken, but I'm gonna hold on to all this and melt it. But I tell you, considering what they've been through, they're doing really good, really good. Let's see, what do we got here? A little nectar and honey. Definitely wanna, look at the red wasps. I'm thinking they were robbing. Don't like those, man. So I'm shaking them off. It's not a lot that can be saved. It's a small, small colony. I had residual bees on the ground and I was real careful to, before I left the scene, to look in those. Those guys were kind of in a hurry. I could have came back and did it tomorrow, but I don't have time for that. I'm gonna be out doing stuff tomorrow that I cannot make it over there, so I had to get them today. I see a lot of squash bees from the fall. I'm looking to see if the queen might have been one. Hopefully she's safe. None of this worth saving, guys. It's all covered. Just double checking to make sure. I don't see where she got squashed. Hopefully she didn't. This is honey and nectar, so maybe she wasn't on this. Very little usable comb. There's more of them red wasps. There were a pile of them in there when I got this thing out, and I was sawing without a veil. And they are just absolutely mean. Oh, there they are. She's trying to get out of that old red wasp. Got her. I don't like those red wasps. I know they're pollinators. Hate to do that, but so they will eat you up down here. So what I'm doing is carefully removing all this sawed up wood, looking for my queen. You guys are gonna move around a little bit the way I got you mounted. This is really a last minute deal. I have not got time to be doing this. I don't do these. Why am I doing this? What have I got myself into? But what do? You say no? He didn't want to kill him. I don't want him dead. I don't want anybody that was coming out there to get him out of this tree. So, you do what you gotta do. I called Mr. Ed and said I got a log full of bees. All right, where's my queen catcher? Gotta be ready, because I'm gonna pull this comb back. I'm gonna look for my queen. I sure hope she made it. Not a biggie, if not, I'll combine them. I'm looking hard. She'll be underneath stuff a lot of times. I don't see her. I'm looking for her here. Let's put this on here. I'm just gonna lay it on that. I got a piece of brood comb in my box. Let's get this honey out of here. There's not a lot of honey in here. Man, there's a lot of dead smashed bees from this when it fell. That's the problem. They dropped this tree. They didn't know they were in there. And you get that. We're gonna just keep looking. Hopefully you didn't squish the queen. That's all you can do. I'm looking for her while I got this comb in my hand. I'm gonna lay this on the box. And I'm gonna glance through here real quick. Look through here really fast. I didn't see her in the log. I don't see her on here. What happens, I'll leave them for a day or so, and if there's no queen, they'll get combined somewhere. Probably with that little nuke that abscond. Here's what we got left in here. She's probably in here, but it's hard to get a good angle on this. There, we got some light. Might have to run them out with some smoke and see if I can get her to move. If I can get her to move. So much debris in here. I've got drawn comb in here. There's some empty frames too, but at least there's drawn comb they can maybe get on. There's no brood in here. I am noticing that so far. Let's see if we can smoke some bees and see if we've got a queen. No brood, and it's not been super cold. We don't just go broodless around here, especially this early. So that's a bit of a concern. It may not even be a queen, but let's smoke them and see. Oh, red wasp. Boy, they're mean. Do you wonder why I'm smoking them, you might ask? Well, I want to spread them out and see if that queen will pop out. There's no cracks or crevices I see that they're going in, so she's probably right there in the group, if she even is in here or alive. And we don't know any of that. All right, so I'm going to run these bees out a little bit. I got some honeybee gone, but I don't really need it because I can see the whole cluster. I'm just trying to spread them out a little bit. Push them all forward. They seem to be mostly nurse bees. I'm guessing all the... I'm going to have to turn this log, I think. See if we can get them going one direction. So far, they're going. But we got to find our queen. All right, we're gonna do some jockeying around here. All right, there we go. Now y'all might even get a better view. So sorry about the camera angles, but best I can do. Okay, we got them opened up. I see a couple more beetles. Nothing unusual there. There's one. I saw one down in the hole. Got them. Oh yeah, now I'm starting to see beetles. Now we're running the beetles out. Look for our queen. They're on the move now. Let's look for our queen. Let's see. Can we find her? Lots of beetles. Lots of beetles. Lots of beetles. I'm looking and I'm not seeing, folks. Oh, there she is. Do I see her? Is that a drone or is that her? I think that's her. I see her. But I can't get to her, folks. She's right down here. I just saw her. I sure did. Just saw her. So I got a queen in here. I got to find her again. She's in that little clump of bees. Couldn't quite grab her with my fingers. She's in there. I saw her. A little brown tail in there. She didn't look too big. Thing is, there's not a ton of honey in here to create a bunch of robbing. Oh, there she is. She's in a hole. She just went down in this hole. I don't want to grab her where I can't reach her good. I can't hardly reach down in there. Can't hardly. Yep, I'm from the south. Let's see if we can get her out of that hole. I just saw her, folks. Oh, there she is. Holy moly, come on out of there. She was coming up. Hold on. She's walking around. There she is. I got her. I got her. Because now I can get this thing out of here and we can stop any robbing. She's little, but she's a queen and she's here. So we're gonna put her on some good fresh comb. We're gonna stick her in this box. We're gonna draw these bees in that box, leave the beetles behind. As you can see, there's plenty of them. Okay, so here's our queen over here. We're gonna cover this comb up. We got robbers showing up. We've got another nuke to nurture. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to end up rubber banding her in there. There's no comb to save. That's actually a blessing because I got plenty of drawing comb to put her on. And we'll get these bees settled. So I'm going to set the box up in such a way that we can draw them in.
All right, I'll be right back.
Okay, so we'll just do our rubber band like so. I'll just lower her in here. I'm not worried about giving them much of nothing right now, just getting her in here. I got some decent comb in here. So what I have is some old brood comb. I'm gonna put that in the middle, but I'm gonna put her in between. I got this, it's drawn out and chewed up and been raw, but that's good too. That'll go to the outside actually, so I need to put that this way. And then a couple of other empty frames, but right now they don't need more than this. It's a small, small colony. They had not a ton of honey in here. They didn't have a lot of honey, and they did not have any brood. So that's an issue right off the bat. She's in here, so we do have a queen, but just gonna put her in there like that. Hope y'all can see them. I probably don't even have y'all focused on here. Let's dump them on there. They know she's there. Now what we're gonna do is smoke the other bees in here. Starting to get some robin bees coming up. There's a little bit of honey in here, not a lot. So we're gonna take this log. I don't want to put the entrance by it for now. But the goal here is to smoke them on in. This log is heavy. This is a typical water oak in the south down here. Hole in the middle. A lot of bee trees are in these things. I'm going to put this brick on here so I don't smash those bees flat. They'll start fanning. I'm going to put a lid on here so that we can close them up and get her pheromone contained. Again, I've got y'all on a weird stand, I'm sorry. I got this brick. This is going to be a terrible video as far as camera angles, but it's just not an ideal. And I'll bring you around here in a second, show you what we got. Let's get this up in the air. Let's pull these bees right in here. And now we can puff a little bit of smoke back there. There they go. There they go. We could probably puff a little bit in the back. We'll see what they do first. Come on, bees. There's a queen in there. Get out of the log. The log is no longer your home. You'll thank me later. You think it's a bad situation. I'm just trying to smoke them up out of there. Just smoke them towards the entrance a little bit. There's no honey in the box for the robbers to go after, so that's good. That's it. That's what we're going to do. We're going to hope they march like a swarm. I'm going to leave y'all sit here. Oh, y'all watch them. I'm going to go get some stuff secured. All right. There you guys go. See what they do. Still got these gals up in here. They don't want to leave. Still smoking there. Just pushing them. I think it went pretty well. Praise the Lord, we found the queen. That's, guys, you guys know that do cutouts. You get that done and it's gravy. They're very gentle. I'm pleased with that. They seem to be very gentle. For everything they've been through, to be as gentle as they were, that could be a very good colony if we can get it through. It's small though. What we have here is just some robbers. This was some old honey in through here. There may be a few residuals, but for the most part, everybody's in. It's gonna be in. What's gonna happen with this colony? I will be putting a frame of honey in there this evening. I'm not gonna do it now. And I'll leave the queen. I'm gonna leave her bottled up for a little bit. See, I gotta wonder who those bees are going in. They're running right back out. See? So those are probably robbers. We're gonna go ahead and move this box all together now. But the goal now is just to get them some food. She's got a place to lay. I'll make sure she has two good frames of comb and a frame of food.
But you're probably going to ask, well, what, or suggest maybe a frame of brood for them. And that did cross my mind, but I'm going to give them about a week before I do that. I don't even know if they have enough bees to cover a frame of brood. And, you know, I don't really want to be digging in any nests right now. There's just not a lot of large frames of brood. I don't want to dig in nests right now on bees that are healthy and settled for this little old colony. I'm going to give them a week and see what they do. And give them a frame. I will grab a frame of honey out of the top of a colony because that's easy. Just grab one, put it in. And then we'll see if we'll give them a boost with brood. But let's release the queen a little bit later. And I'll do a quick shot of that. And then we'll see about a frame of brood in another week or so. Well, after Thanksgiving. Here's where we stand. What do we know about this colony? What we know is they had no brood. They did have a queen. There was some honey in it, but most of it got smashed and opened up at the site. And then there was a little bit here, very little. They're trying to get in that tote. But what I'm going to do is keep that tote closed. So we know that about them. We know they had a lot of beetles, but I think we were able to get a lot of bees in and leave a lot of beetles behind. Another thing we know is we got robin going on. See this? Look, they're hitting that tailgate because that's where the log was. There they are on log. These are all robbers at this point. We got to stem the robbing. Your question might be, how will I do that? I'm taking this down the road and dumping it. It is way too late to be messing with cutouts. What is going on? All right, guys, I popped the lid and pulled the queen out. Here she is. They're definitely happy she's here. I pulled a frame of honey from that colony right over there. I'm gonna stick it right on the side here. They're a little bit irritated. Oh, goodness. I'm gonna let her go now. Not yet. Not yet, old girl. Oh, yeah, they're a little irritated now. Let's get them out of here. This is what I pulled out. I didn't pull a huge frame of honey out. It's not a huge colony. I really didn't want to. I want to see how they do. I mentioned I'm not putting any brood in here. I'm not digging in colonies right now at this time for brood. So I've got the empty frame out, and I'm going to show you what I'm doing with my polystyrene. Now, the polystyrene was an idea for that one, which I'm going to also do here in a minute. But Brad, that bee man, Faith Apiaries, and mainly the sentimental bloke, he suggested it, a fellow named Jay Rittenhour, is not even a beekeeper, and he said, maybe a thin piece of insulation on each side. Well, my polystyrene that I already had cut, I didn't want to cut into a new board just yet, wasn't wide in the right size and everything to go in, so I stuck them in these frames for now. It's going to leave a little bit of dead space, but I think it'll fill space. It won't be able to build, and it'll be added insulation. So, hey, here we go. Let's put this one this way. They're kind of irritated. It's done got dark. It's cool out. I've done let out their heat. I'm not helping them any. Like I said, I'm not giving them brood, guys. Not yet. Because I want to see how they do. I'm not going to start digging into good colonies. Let's get you off of there. All right, let's see. Can we let this queen go? Yep, she's still in there. She's a little queen. She might be a new one, too. Who knows? Because there was no brood. Let's let her go. There she is. There she is. Get on there. There she went. Down she goes. All right, she's released. She's in. There you go. That's all we can do. We give them some food. I might give them brood in another week or so. Let me see how they do if they stabilize.
I guess I need to put a piece of pollen on there because there's no pollen. I just hate it with the beetles, and there were a lot of beetles in there. Just be careful with the pollen sub. I'm only going to put a little piece on there, and we're going to see what they do. They're small. Here, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you don't mind, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Hey, and don't forget to share this video with friends, family, anybody that just enjoys watching bees. Y'all have a wonderful, wonderful afternoon. May the Lord God bless you. We'll see y'all later.